Lab objective: learn how to use GitHub repositories to manage and perform basic Git operations, such as creating repositories, committing changes, branching, and merging. Gain hands-on experience with GitHub's user interface and CLI for efficient version control. Lab purpose: GitHub is a leading platform for hosting and collaborating on software development projects using Git. This lab demonstrates how to use GitHub to manage repositories, track changes, and collaborate with others, empowering you to work efficiently on coding projects. This lab requires you to have a GitHub account and Git CLI installed on your local machine. If you do not have Git CLI installed, just follow the walkthrough to configure and set up the Git command line interface on your machine. First, sign up or log in to your GitHub account on github.com. Then click this link to navigate into Git SCM webpage to download the command line interface to your machine. After you have the installer, just install it. Now you can open your terminal and configure Git with your name and email. In my case, I am utilizing PowerShell to configure it. Here I am on my desktop directory and using Git CLI tool with its parameters to configure the username and also the user email address. Now follow the task 2 where you create your first repository on GitHub. Using the web interface, you first create your remote repository on GitHub platform. Then utilize local repository and connect them together. Click the plus icon in the upper right corner of the GitHub interface. Select New Repository. Name the repository My Dash First Repo. Select Public or Private, then click Create Repository. On your terminal, make a new directory, then navigate into that directory by typing CD and folder name. Here I'm just going to clear this up. Then type Git init to initialize. After that, you need to configure the remote origin for this repository. Now in the task 3, we will create a new README file and commit the changes to the local repository. Now create a new README file with a one header. Then update the repository using Git add. By typing commit command, you can specify the new update to the repository. So in the next step, we need to connect our machine with the GitHub platform. To do that, we will be using GitHub personal access tokens. To create a new personal access token, we can utilize GitHub web interface and generate a new one via settings menu. Now on github.com, select settings. Scroll down and select developer settings. Then select personal access tokens. Choose tokens. Click generate new token button and select classic version. Sign in one more time. Give it a note and choose expiration date. Now check all of the permissions and click Generate Token button. Now copy the token. Now we need to configure connection between our machine and GitHub. Type this command along with the new access token that you have. Now we can push the changes to the origin master branch on GitHub. Here, check your repository for a new change. As you can see, we have the README file in this repo now. Now we can create our local feature branch to make updates to the repository. So this way we can have clean history of changes to the main repository. The next task is to create a new branch and make a new change in that branch. Here, using echo command, I'm going to add a new line of text. If you type this command, you can see the update on the file. Now use add command, then commit the changes. Finally, push the change to the new feature branch. Here, refresh your repo page to see a new branch added. Click this button to create a new pull request. Now create a pull request. Now it is checking for any change conflicts. Now I can merge the new pull request to the base branch. Confirm the merge. After that, we can delete that feature branch from our repo. Here, check your repository for a new change on README file. Finally, on the last task, you need to delete the merged branch. Type git checkout master to change the working branch, then use branch and dflag to delete the branch. Thank you.